Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. How are you guys doing today? I hope you all are safe and well. And this video is going to be another sneaker unboxing for you all. So before I talk about the sneakers, I just want to talk about different categories that I'm going to divide my sneaker unboxings in. As I talked about in my introduction video as well, that I'm not going to unbox just high-end or costly sneakers in this channel, but I will be talking about a lot of budget sneakers as well. So I'm going to divide my sneaker unboxings into four categories. The first category would be economical or cheap sneakers, which would range up to 3,000 rupees. The second category would be budget sneakers. Budget sneakers are anything which are up to 6,000 rupees. And the fourth category would be a little costly sneakers, but I was able to get those sneakers on retail. Sneakers, you know, that could range around 10,000 rupees. And the fourth category would be high-end sneakers on sneakers. For which I had to pay resale. So today, the sneakers I will be talking about would be Vans Skate High, which come in this Vans Red Classic box. And the color that I'm going to show you guys would be the burgundy color. Now, these are actually Comfy Kush sneakers. Now, Comfy Kush sneakers are basically an enhanced version of Vans Classic Skate Highs. The difference between both the sneakers is just that these sneakers are a little more padded compared to the normal skate highs. If you want, I can probably make a video to compare both these sneakers as well, because I do have a normal skate high as well. Now, these sneakers were actually launched in 1978, and these sneakers are only the second model which included the Vans side stripe. Now, the side stripe was actually known as Jazz Stripe initially. But they're just called as Vans Side Stripe. The best thing about these sneakers are that they look good on everything. On shorts, they look really nice on denims as well. I personally prefer to wear these sneakers with denims. So here is a close look of the sneakers. As you can see, the toe, the ice stay, and the side of the sneakers is in suede. And here you can see the white side stripe. And over here, there's a small portion of the sneaker which is in canvas. And on the back as well, there is a suede material used in the sneakers. Apart from that, if I talk about the tongue is also in suede. And the best part about the sneakers or the tongue is that the inside of the tongue, you can see a little black padding, which actually feels really comfortable towards your feet. Whole sock line area is padded as well, which again feels really comfortable towards your feet. And also, if I talk about the sole, you know, it actually feels a little, you know, like a cushion, like a soft cushion sole that's being used. And if I talk about the bottom, here you can see the classic Vans waffle bottom being used, you know, which is very durable. And that's the best part about Vans sneakers, that they're very durable and you can actually wear these for a very long time. Also, the sneaker comes with white flat laces. I'll quickly lace these sneakers up and show you how they look on feet as well. So now I'll quickly show you guys how to lace up sneakers. Now you must be thinking ki lacing to ek hi tarike se hoti hai. Actually tarika same hi hota hai, but you can style it up in three different ways. Not just three, actually in a lot of different ways. In this video, I'll show you three different ways how you can style your laces on a sneaker. So I'll quickly get started. Also, before I get started, let me quickly cut these tags over here. And cutting these tags means only one thing, that I cannot return the sneakers now. Right, and so this is basically factory lacing of how, you know, sneakers come. Now the first thing you actually need to do is to make sure that both of these are equal. So you just have to take your first aglet. Now this is known as aglet, if a lot of people didn't know. The lace tip is known as aglet. Just have to put it over here. And the second one on the top of it, you just have to cross it. Now like this, we'll continue till the end of the loops, yeah?
Now we have a little lace loop over here, you know. So this lace loop basically helps to hold the tongue, you know, with the laces, so that it doesn't go, you know, so that it doesn't fall when you're wearing these sneakers. Now there are three different ways that I'm going to show you how you can lace up your sneakers and how they will look on feet as well. Now the first way is basically to lace up your sneakers till you know, till the last hole. So a lot of people who, you know, who do not prefer you know, to show their upper of the sneaker, you know, style the sneakers like this, and I'll quickly show you how they look on feet as well. Now I personally do not prefer to lace my sneakers like this, because I prefer, you know, the tongue, you know, to come out of the denim, the lower of the denim. So I prefer wearing my sneakers by just, you know, bringing this one, bringing the laces out of the last top loop. Personally feel that it looks much better than the last one. So probably you can try that as well. People in India were not aware, you know, to lace up their sneakers. So that way is basically you do, you know, lace up your sneakers till the last loop, but actually you do not tie those laces. What you actually do is you just loosen up the laces a little bit from here, and let me show you. So basically you just, you know, you just have to ensure the right, just like this. So basically you wear your sneakers with the laces out like this. Now people who do not like to you know, who do not like to wear their sneakers too tight actually prefer wearing these sneakers like this. I'll give you a quick look how these look on feet as well. I do like wearing my Air Force One mostly like this. I actually style them mostly like this as well. Now, as I was lacing my second shoe, I thought of showing you other ways how you can lace up your sneakers. Also guys, if you do think that any of the other styles, if you do like any of the other styles of lacing up the sneakers, do let me know in the comment section. And also if you want me to, you know, show you more ways how you can, you know, lace up your sneakers, and not just these, but any of the other sneakers as well. I would love to, you know, probably make a, you know, make a video on how you can, you know, lace up your sneakers in different ways. Right, so in this time, you basically lace up your sneakers to the third last hole, and you know what you can probably do is, and then instead of going above the tongue, you actually go beneath the tongue and directly go in the last hole. And you just have to loosen it up a little bit to give it a little loose effect. And just to tighten these a little bit so that the laces beneath the tongue doesn't really bother you. Right. So basically this is how it could look. Now you can see that one hole is missing over here, and from the inside as well, the laces, you know, would be too close to the tongue, so it would not bother you, or you know, so this would not, you know, come in your way when you're wearing the sneakers. So this is also a good alternative how you can lace up your sneakers. This is just, you know, one of the one of the decisive ways. You know, people would be thinking that laces are not in the second last hole, but they are in the last hole. So just for fun, you can probably try these out. I also learned this from one of the YouTube videos. So you can also probably try this as well. Thank you.
prefer going upper size for skate highs. They do have a little narrow bottom, so I prefer going upper size so that, you know, the sneakers fit more comfortably, and actually I feel better with upper size, and specifically for this model, because this sneaker has got more padding towards the heel area and towards the toe as well. They actually fit really well, so I had to go for UK 10. Now talking about pricing, guys, I bought these sneakers from Ajio. Now the retail price on these sneakers is 9,000 rupees, but I paid 3,900 rupees, which to be very honest is a steal deal, because that's almost 55% discount that I got on these sneakers, and I feel that, you know, getting these sneakers at 3,900 rupees is absolutely amazing. And I would suggest you guys also to check these sneakers out on Ajio. They are available in a couple of other colors as well, so you can probably check those colors out as well. And I personally believe that you should definitely go for these sneakers, because A, they look great on feet, B, they're very comfortable, and C, they're not that costly. Now, you know, because everybody cannot afford to buy Jordans all the time. They do cost a lot. So I feel that you know, if you can get these sneakers at, you know, 3,500 to 4,000 rupees, then these are a must pop. And I'm really happy that I got these sneakers for such an amazing price, especially this color, because this was the color that was missing in my collection as of now. So that's it for today. I hope that you liked the video. If you did, please you know, click that thumbs up button, subscribe to my channel, and also comment down below that what are your thoughts about these sneakers, or if you already had these sneakers and which color, and or if you did not, would you like to try these sneakers or not? So thank you all.